Hey there, it's Kaylee. This lesson is on finding the fraction of a set. All right, let's get started. John has five houses. If he paints two of the five houses green and the rest orange, what will his houses look like? Yeah, like this. So what fractions of the houses are green? Two out of the five houses are green, which we can write as 2/5. And which fraction of the houses are orange? 3/5. Now John buys more houses, so now he has 10 houses. If he paints 2/5 of the houses green, how many of the houses will be green? This is the same as asking, what is 2/5 of 10? Remember, in word problems, the word of can typically be replaced with a multiplication sign. So this asks us, what is 2/5 times 10? When working with fractions, let's make sure every number has a numerator and a denominator. So for our whole number 10, we'll just give it a denominator of 1. And now we can multiply straight across our numerator. 2 times 10 is 20. And straight across our denominator, 5 times 1 is 5. So we have 20/5. And we can simplify using our 5 fact families. 5 goes into 20 4 times. So in the case of having 10 houses, John would paint 4 of them green. That's called finding the fraction of a set. Let's do some more of these problems together. So here, this one's asking us, what's 1/7 of 28? So we're finding the fraction 1/7 of the set 28. And remember, we can rewrite of as multiplication. So we get 1/7 times 28. I'm going to add a 1 down here in my denominator because I'm working with fractions. And then I can just multiply across my numerator. 1 times 28 is 28. And across my denominator, 7 times 1 is 7. So now I have 28/7, which is an improper fraction, but I can do quick little division here. Thinking about your 7 fact family, 7 goes into 28 4 times, with 0 left over. So our answer is 4. Good work. Let's do one more together. And here, this one, we're finding a fraction 1/3 of the set 57. So 1/3 of 57. I'm rewriting my of as a multiplication sign. So I have 1/3 times 57. I'm going to rewrite my whole number 57 as a fraction. So I just put a 1 in the denominator. And now I can multiply across my numerator. 1 times 57 is 57. Across my denominator, 3 times 1 is 3. So I have the improper fraction 57/3. So let's do some division. See if we get a mixed number or a whole number. So 3 goes into 5 1 time. 1 times 3 is 3. I subtract here. I get a 2. I bring down my 7. 3 goes into 27. If you know from your 3 fact family, 9 times. That gives me 27 with 0 left over. So I get the whole number, 19, as my answer. Good work. So now you can practice these on your own. Remember that this of here can always be rewritten as a multiplication sign, and then it's just fraction multiplication. So practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun, and remember to always be clever. Hey!